Did you know this podcast is powered by Acast? Acast is the home of podcasting. For creators looking for freedom to grow their listeners and make money too. And creative brands looking for smart ways to advertise. Podcasters and advertisers in the know Acast. It's time you did too. Visit acast.com to find out more. Acast, for the stories.
Can you believe they're making a new Mario movie? Ooh. And oh boy, the cast.
Oh yeah, you're going to have to wait till the end for that one, but my lord, it's a doozy.
Listen, if you haven't already heard the cast, it'll be worth it probably at the end for where you and I both lose our minds.
Yeah, we'll have to get through the fucking terribleness of Blizzard news, but...
Don't worry, your Blizzard expert is right here.
Yeah. So what bothers me about these Boston alternative jerseys...
Oh, yeah, by the way, I have the Yankee game on because, you know, we're at the end of the season and these assholes want to try to not make the playoffs, apparently. Yeah.
It bothers me, and this is hypocritical in a way, because obviously the Yankees have their thing going on where they have their jerseys that say New York in the front.
And then they have their hats
that have the NY on.
Yeah, the home logo.
But for some reason, the Boston ones that say Boston on their jersey and they have the B on their hat, It really bothers me that they're different fonts.
It's annoying specifically in the City Connect jersey because the Boston becomes a different font.
Yes.
On their normal, like, normally that would be, their alternative would say Red Sox.
Mm-hmm.
And it's in the same font as the B on the hat. Yeah. So It's just like there's not congruency throughout the uniform.
Yeah.
Like the B should also be fully yellow.
Yeah.
Not outlined in yellow.
Yeah. Because then you'd have like a nice flow going on.
Yeah. But listen, Nike and New Era, the hat guys. Or Majestic. Oh, no, Majestic does another thing. Whatever. Those guys did some really weird designs to the point where during the season, I think it was around the All-Star break, there were people actively wondering, and legitimately so, if designers at those companies were letting their kids use MS Paint to come up with the hat designs.
I think the problem is, since we're like way in the weeds on this, but I do think it's kind of that issue. It's where they're having younger people do the designs. And it's just like...
I think they're having younger, unqualified people do the designs. It's either that or the old people they have doing them lost their minds in the pandemic.
Could be that.
And just actively devolved into, you know what? I'm going to put a picture of the Golden Gate Bridge, a picture of a beer, and whatever. I don't know what else. Can I put anything else on the hat? That was one of the hats, by the way. It was an A's and San Francisco hat. So it had like a beer or an alcohol beverage. The Golden Gate Bridge, but not aligned.
On there.
Oh, it looked like those denim patch jackets that people wear, but like the patches weren't put on with any agency, like any order at all.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some of them were upside down or sideways or at 33 degree angles. Like, oh.
Hey, this is a video game podcast. It's called Gamers 2.
That's a stretch.
It's your weekly roundup of news and commentary related to the video game industry. And anything else that we, you know, care to talk about. Like random baseball design jersey bullshit.
Which we do quite well.
Yep. Yeah. That's it, I think. That's it. Hey, there's a Jeep for sale down the road.
There is. There's a Jeep for sale down the road.
I stopped and looked at it.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Did they have price in the window?
They did not. They had a phone number. But I was surprised about how little rust there was on it. So that piqued my interest a little bit. But I think I have enough broken down cars in my driveway. So I'll have to restrain myself.
You could start just looking like your neighbor and put a bunch of broken cars in your lawn, driveway, everywhere.
Yeah.
And then just randomly scream obscenities into the void.
Yep.
You guys have become new best friends.
could definitely do that.
The So my issue with buying Jeeps. Do we want to do video games or should we just tangent
We could do video games, I guess. I mean, unless you really want to talk about Jeeps.
Well, I'll say this. All right. My issue with buying Jeeps doesn't matter when the price is too high.
Yeah, they're
stupid.
Which is a double-edged sword. Because, like,
it's good if you buy a new one because your resale, you don't lose money, essentially. You know, it's that angle.
What's interesting about that specific one and why I'm kind of curious about the price, that's the Jeep that's going to go up in value.
Right, but that's also why I'm betting the price is stupid.
Yeah.
Because the reason they pulled it out was last weekend. Last weekend when we were recording, there was that snowmobile race stuff going on. It's the
biggest
biggest touring event. They pulled it out that weekend. It's the same reason the boat's out there. There were a bunch of other cars randomly throughout town that were for sale. People had snowmobile trailers out. Like, anything that anybody needs to sell at that point gets pulled to the side of the road with a for sale sign on it and says, please buy me. No one ever does, and here we are.
Yeah.
They just haven't pulled it back yet. Because it's not going to sit there, obviously, for the winter.
Mm-hmm.
But my guess is they're asking way more money than it should be worth. And that's not even saying that it runs or is in good condition. It's a convertible, no top, no doors. I don't know if they have the doors or if they even have the soft top for it. So you'd be in that situation where you'd have to buy another soft top and doors.
No, I don't want to say... When I say no floors, what I mean is that the inside's also gutted. So, like, it's got seats, but there's no floors actual, pulled up, and all the... Like, I don't know enough about that model of Jeep, but, like, all the drain plugs for the floors are pulled out, too. So, like, there's holes in the floor to, you know, like, allow liquids to go through. So, it's not like... It's like a beach Jeep, essentially.
Yeah, you'd essentially be limited to good weather beach Jeep
or
a conversion into actually being able to use it in the winter.
Yeah.
Which a conversion would cost you $4,000.
Yeah.
All said and done.
The Jeep to find, and I could have bought one like 2 years ago, and I wish I did.
Oh, now we're off talking. Okay.
The post service Jeeps.
Oh. Those are not easy to find.
No. But
I mean, for a reason, same reason you can't find a true Crown Vic.
When at one point, like years ago, they were
tuned Crown Vic.
They were cheap as shit. Now, like, everyone's onto them, and they're like, ooh.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyways,
you need to go over by work so you can go to the guy. I haven't bothered to look it up, and I haven't bothered to stop either to see what it actually is to look it up and tell you. But there's that hatch that's still sitting over there. And every time I see that hatch, an old hatch, and I'm just like, I got a spare stall. I can check it out right in my garage.
Hey, if you don't care about cars, you don't care about baseball, you might care about new video games to take up your time.
Such as number one, Super Arcade Football for the Switch. Number two, Kena Bridge of Spirits for the PC, PlayStations. That game is officially out.
Congratulations.
Silently, because you didn't hear much about it this week, because there was a lot of other stuff going on.
Probably sucks. Oh. Shots fired.
Potion Craft for the PC. Potion Craft, take a guess what publisher pushed that one.
Potion Craft pushed it.
Not like they published it. Our friends over at Tiny Build.
Oh, Tiny Build. That does sound like a Tiny Build game.
Number four, Sheltered 2 for the PC. Number five, World War Z Aftermath. Also the same way I've described some bathrooms I've been in. Number six, Rover Mechanic Simulator for the Xboxes. Number seven, Source of Madness for the PC. Number eight, Test Drive Unlimited Solar Crown for the PC, PlayStation, Xbox, and Switch. Number nine, Diablo 2 Resurrected. Holy shit, a game came out.
I heard it's having some issues with bugs.
And launch day was a server nightmare.
Yeah. Yeah.
Number 10, Ember, PC, PlayStation, Xbox, and Switch. Number 11, Floofies Adventure for the PC. Number 12, MechWarrior 5 Mercenaries for the PlayStation. Number 13, Medieval Dynasty for the PC. Number 14, Sable for the PC and Xbox. Number 15, Sea of Thieves got a new season. Number 16, Death Stranding Director's Cut. Oh, God. Number 17, Dragon Ball Z Kakarot for the Switch. And number 18, Lost Judgment, More Yakuza for Lost the PlayStation Xbox.
Judgment. Joey Gallo's pants are really tight.
They're not as tight as Walker Buehler's.
I don't know. His thighs were just about to rip out of those pants.
You need to see Robbie Ray and Walker Buehler.
And I was turned on by it. what the fuck? What are we doing here?
What are you feeling? I'm feeling even.
Even.
Is that my normal path? Even.
That's the third week in a row.
You know what that means? I'm doing odds. Here we go. Number one.
I mean, you can stick with evens. Nope, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that.
You criticized me last week, so I tried to switch it, and I was wrong.
I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong.
Number one. Don't be out here trying to, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. We're not supposed to be that polite to each other.
All right. Well, I'm just trying to be honest. All right. My brain no work good. Could be wrong.
No good. Bad brain. Right? That's the joke. Bad brain. Got a case of the bad brain.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, might as well start off with the crap news, which might as well start off with me.
It continues for a while. Don't worry.
Blizzard's woes continue in a multitude of ways. Activision Blizzard is now facing two or more investigations, making the count three in total. According to the Wall Street Journal, the Securities and Exchange Commission, also known as the SEC, has opened its own investigation into Activision Blizzard's response to sexual misconduct and workplace harassment allegations. The SEC has requested a variety of documents from the publisher, including CEO Bobby Kotick's communications with other high-level executives about the allegations. Beyond that, the regulator wants to see separation agreements with employees who left this year, personnel files for six former employees, and board meeting minutes going back 2 years. One of the issues the SEC is looking into is whether Activision Blizzard had an obligation to inform investors about the investigation into workplace and gender pay gap allegations before it was made public. That's what we in the books call insider training. Trading. Not training. Trading.
A little both.
We train them to do it inside.
I'm just gonna rip right into number two because it's semi-relevant to the same one. Continuing on the same topic, the second investigation the public is learning about is by the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission. The EEOC has reportedly been looking into allegations of gender-based harassment at the publisher since at least May 2020. And it is said to be in settlement talks with Activision, which could end up paying millions of dollars. In case you're keeping score at home, the first investigation that kickstarted this situation came out from the California Department for Fair Employment and Housing back in July, which filed a lawsuit. So we have three government entities all investigating Activision Blizzard. One has filed a lawsuit. One was investigating in at least May of 2020.
I'm wondering if some of these groups are like annoyed that California pulled the trigger.
I'm also wondering that because I kind of get the feeling that California was like the California entity was like late to the party, and the other two like had things going on, and now they're like the doors have been blown open.
Yeah, because I have seen that not with like these commissions, but with people before where, you know, someone's working really hard to get something done, and then the Kool-Aid man just kicks it in. And it's like, good news, it's fixed. You're like, what the fuck, man? I had this whole speech I was going to give, and you just walked in here and said it was him? It's like when you see the old, I think that's a trope in a lot of comedic detective shows. Like, I was going to lay out this whole, I was going to replay the whole thing, explain how he did it, and you just got to come in here and just say he did it, and we're out of here? Come on.
So classic.
But of course, you know, things just always going wrong over there. Speaking of that, number three, more Activision Blizzard news as the company slash companies saw a couple notable departures this week. Claire Hart, Blizzard Entertainment's chief legal officer, said, "I'm fucking out of here," announced her departure on LinkedIn on Monday. She worked at Blizzard for more than 3 years, prior to which she spent over a decade at Google. If I had to deal with potentially three government lawsuits, I'd be out too. Next up is Chaco Sonny, the executive producer of Overwatch. Bloomberg reports Sonny informed colleagues via email that Friday will be his final day at Blizzard. Sonny's note did not give a reason for leaving. Several anonymous Blizzard employees told Bloomberg the executive producer was well-respected and that, to their knowledge, no allegations have been made against him. This is Nate speculating now. Probably again. Fuck this shit. I'm out of here.
Fuck this shit. I'm out. Yeah. What a shit show.
And Diablo 2 came out.
Yeah, I know. That's the crazy thing. It's like Diablo 2 came out not having the greatest launch, and that's like not even like...
Not even the number one story in Blizzard right now.
Yep. Not even noteworthy, because... Oh my god, it's great. I don't know. I mean, it looks bad on surface, but it's kind of like... I'm kind of hopeful, because I feel like... Instead of like having like a situation to where it's like death by a thousand cuts, it's literally like ripping the Band-Aid off. Like, it's just going to be this horrible thing that maybe goes across like 2 years or maybe hopefully a year. And then like you have rebuild.
Yeah, it sucks that we're doing this. But at the same time, like, these are the things that regardless, we need to see people out.
Yeah.
And just hopeful change coming in, and them getting sued by more than California is good in that respect.
Yeah.
Like, okay, cool. Maybe they would have potentially gotten away with California, but now when the SEC is like, oh, no, and you're insider trading, like, nah, fuck you. And then the other one's like, oh, and you've been doing equality things incorrect the entire time? Double fuck you.
The one thing I don't necessarily like is the one entity, I can't remember which one, what was the last one? I think it was like the...
EEOC?
Yeah.
Or EE...
You're right.
Yeah, EEOC. Yeah. I pulled that out of my ass.
Talking about settling.
Yeah.
I'm not a big fan.
Yeah, No. We're not here to settle.
Yeah, no settlements.
We're
going to
settle for spending a few million dollars. Yeah, that's like one Call of Duty window. We'll be all right.
Yeah. $1 million to Activision Blizzard is pocket change.
$10 million probably doesn't even count the amount that gets spent on a battle pass on a new Call of Duty season.
Yeah.
So let's not settle here, people. Let's take actual action. Actionable change.
Actionable change. What would be nice is like criminal charges against people who deserve them.
Oh, for sure. I mean, that'd be ideal, but like,
not like
let's be realistic. Or even not necessarily criminal. I mean, I would take criminal charges against the ones that deserve it, but also like civil charges where they're like, no, you personally need to go pay this person.
Yeah.
Not the company's not going to cover you. You need to do this.
Anything that results in like the rot getting pulled out. But I mean, honestly, like, I'm over the top with it because I'm very much like, you know, eat the rich. But
okay. All right. Let's not start.
Bobby Kotick.
He's not here.
Bobby Kotick, like, out would be, I'd be very thrilled with that, personally.
If that came out, like, this week, or, you know, even in the next month, people would just be like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
It's the moment of, like, oh, all right.
The only downside, though, is, like, it's the CEOs, it's just, like, fucking, like, musical chairs.
Yes.
It's never, you're never going to get really fresh blood. You're just going to get someone else of the same ilk. So.
Yeah.
All right. Is it me? Am I up?
Yep.
I'm even.
Quattro Quattro.
Number four. A new website has been launched in China urging people to report any video games or companies that do not comply with the nation's recently increased restrictions on gaming. The South China Morning Post reports that this website, titled Zadoozy, reporting platform for gaming companies' implementation of anti-addiction regulations, end quote.
.com.
is currently in a trial phase. The website requires a Chinese ID and mobile phone number to make a report, with incidents grouped under three categories. The categories are whether an online game is accompanying with the is complying with the requirements for real name registrations by all users, whether an online game has implemented the new time limits for players under 18, and whether an online game has taken steps to prevent teenagers from spending too much on in-game transactions. There you have it. I guess if you're Chinese, go, you know, report some of your fellow countrymen.
You and Texas can get together on a bounty program.
Ooh. I like it. I like it.
Oh, jeez.
Pull in those references. What is the world coming to? Let's stop. Let's take a break for a second.
Oh, do we need to do this?
Just a quick second. What has happened in the past 2 years besides COVID?
It's building longer than that.
It has, but I feel like it's just been the ramp up, the exponential increase.
Well, I guess in theory, right? Do we want to? So, hold on. Let me just crack these knuckles and get real down to the brass tacks of the situation. So when I say it's been going on for years, I guess what I mean is shit. I guess what I mean is that's a 3-0 home run to Rafael Devers and the score is 7-3. We've been.
You thought they were gonna win?
I didn't say that. I said I cursed this by turning it on.
Yes.
The years prior to now, prior to the last 2 years that you're referencing, we've been setting up the dominoes.
Oh, yeah.
We've been just setting up all these beautiful, elaborate course that when given the opportunity, just going to flick the first one and watch everything get destroyed.
I mean, I feel like, it's timely because it's happened recently, but I think for at least the U.S., September 11th was the first turning point there to where like things were just like, okay, we don't need, I don't want to say that. It's kind of aggressive, but
how aggressive were you about to get?
I don't know. Video game podcast. Where are we at here? Oh, it's your turn.
Is it? Oh yeah. Quattro.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. We don't need to. We don't, we don't need
it's
to.
It's just interesting.
Yeah, there's a lot of, we are not that podcast, but we are those people where if we had a second podcast, holy shit, the things that would come out of our mouths. Can you believe?
It always, like, reminds me of, like, the Peter Griffin, you know, it grinds my gears segment.
You know it really grinds my gears?
Yeah.
I can't do a Peter Griffin.
Peter.
Lois. No, that's not Lois. No, that's not Peter. That's, I don't know what am I even doing? Number five. Twitch has signed an agreement with the National Music Publishers Association over the use of copyrighted music on its platform. This deal means that music publishers will be, quote, offered an opt-in deal allowing for future collaborations, end quote. In an email sent to streamers, as reported by Kotaku, it's clarified that this will make for a process that is more flexible and forgiving to creators who inadvertently or incidentally use music in their streams than the existing process required under the DMCA and similar global laws. In practice, that means that content creators who feature copyrighted music in their streams will be given a chance to course correct first, with Twitch giving a warning before removing the content. So real quick.
Yes.
A step in the right direction, but not what people are asking for.
No, I thought, I feel like it's kind of like shiesty that they signed an agreement. This is almost like preferential treatment for Twitch. You know what I mean? Like,
wait,
you get where I'm coming from?
I think I do, but I want you to elaborate it.
So,
I think I know what you mean.
Why does Twitch get this arrangement over like YouTube or another situation?
Okay, that's what I thought you meant.
Like, it seems shiesty to me to give one entity preferential treatment.
And my guess is it's not an exclusive thing. It's just a matter of,
like Twitch said,
they're going to try to get it done first.
Yeah,
and
like it's like Twitch is like, we'll help you police it, but as long as we do it this way.
Yeah. Because there's already the copyright claim thing on YouTube where you can just YouTube needs to do a whole rework on a lot of their stuff.
YouTube's hot fucking garbage right now.
This is one of the more, not counting like the racist and the all the other stuff that's going on Twitch, but like from a Twitch down perspective, is like this is one of the easier things that they could fix right now in terms of like just get the. But the issue with me is that it's, hey, you're just going to get the chance to not do it. Where, why, when you're already making this deal, not just make a curated library provided by Twitch from those people that say, hey, you're good to just use these on your stream. Everything you use in this grouping is fine.
I think, don't they already have something like that?
They don't officially. The pretzel thing I mentioned before is done by them, just like an offshoot that is by people that have said, yeah, you can use it, whatever. Mm-hmm. So they're working on like their own side thing. But like, why is there not a Twitch solution to, we have a curated list of things that people have said, yes, it's okay, you can do this.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know.
Rather than just, oh, all right, you can ask us first now.
Yeah.
I mean, it's better than a direct slap. It's like, I'm going to slap you unless is where they're at.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Won't slap you if you give me $5.
Yeah. Okay. So that's the next thing is, like, when does that become a thing?
Yep.
Or like, you'll get a subscription service to where like you pay X amount of money a month and, you know, you essentially get like a couple freebies a month or something like that.
I don't even want to say what's on my mind, but I'm going to do it. To really piss in everybody's Wheaties, we know that Twitch has tiers of their subscribers, but they like ban you from talking about it. Where you, when you get the affiliate, I'm going to go straight to when you get to partner, skipping affiliate. When you get partner, it's the same cut at the entry level as affiliate, where I think it's 50-50. 50 goes to Twitch and 50 comes to you.
Okay.
I'm not 100% like, yeah, on these numbers.
These are just stand-in numbers.
But this is what I'm going with. 50-50.
Illustrate a point.
When you hit a certain threshold of amount of subscribers, the cut Twitch takes is now less. So their top end have like exclusive deals to not take, like Twitch will only take 10% of their sub number versus 50.
I mean, it's like the same way US taxes work.
And the same way Steam is treated, like,
yeah,
game shares and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing. So what I could see Twitch doing, and this is again to piss in everybody's Wheaties, saying, hey, if you have 1,000 subs a month, you can pick from this catalog, but it starts at you have to have 1,000 subs a month.
Okay.
Everybody below you, fuck them.
And then, like, obviously, like, the high-end streamers get a way bigger catalog to choose from or something crazy like that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, even just starting at 1,000 subs a month eliminates so many people.
Yeah.
So they wouldn't even probably have to worry about the higher end versus not, because even
I get what you're saying, high end subs, yeah,
and the true high end, they'd fight for them anyway.
Oh yeah, they
wouldn't care.
They would license music for them.
Yeah, they would immediately just be like, "What did you do? That's fine."
Yeah, nuts.
So interesting.
Yeah, I mean, we'll see how it develops. Number six, Epic CEO Tim Sweeney posted.
Here we go.
Yeah. Posted a pair of emails on Twitter. The first one is an email he sent to Apple last week saying that Epic has paid $6 million to Apple as ordered by the judge and requesting the reactivation of the company's developer account. The second email was a response from Apple's legal representation pointing out that the judge had ruled the termination of Epic's developer license was valid. Quote, Apple has exercised its discretion not to reinstate Epic's developer program account at this time. Furthermore, Apple will not consider any further requests for reinstatement until the district court's judgment becomes final and non-appealable. Which I don't think is a word, by the way. And
non-appealable?
Quote, yeah.
Wouldn't it just be hyphened?
It might be hyphened, but they could just say unappealable. Sweeney said the appeals process on the case could take 5 years. Sweeney also said via Twitter, quote, I like this. This is spicy. Apple lied. Apple spent a year telling the world, the court, and the press they'd, quote, welcome Epic's return to the App Store if they agree to play by the same rules as everyone else, end quote. Epic agreed, and now Apple has reneged in another abuse of its monopoly power over a billion users, end quote.
Fight the system, man. Fight the system. I love when you corporations just fight over each other.
Yeah.
You're so cute when you fight.
It's so cute.
Oh, look at you. Let me just throw another wad of hundreds at you. Oh, you like that, don't you, you dirty bitch?
Oh, shit. Fantastic.
You remember when Epic did the whole thing of militarizing its children?
Oh, to like, yeah.
This is a stretch in the term, but you know what I'm talking about?
Like, they turn their fans on.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it would be really, like, they basically were like, you know,
they were
really
dropping
cool
propaganda
yeah.
and, like, militarizing their fans, and it's like, here we go again.
God, so ridiculous.
It is. So, yes. Apple's technically correct. The judge did rule that that was okay.
Yeah.
And yada yada. Tim's also correct. They technically reneged.
Yeah, true.
Like,
true.
If you said you were going to do it, and then a result came, and you're like, we're going to appeal that again. And it's like, all right, well.
I got something similar that gives me similar feelings. So there's, as you know, you've probably seen, heard, a little bit of...
I see and hear a lot of things.
This pertains to the European Union and Apple.
And, oh.
Yeah,
the chargers?
We're getting in the charger cables.
Hell, I'm so happy about this, by the way.
Okay, so I knew you would be.
Yeah.
Which I'm on the opposite side of this.
Of course you are, you fucking nerd. You fanboy. You
I'm
Apple
not a fanboy. I am not a fanboy. With that said, yes, I've seen this all the shit like USB-C is more capable than Lightning.
I don't give a fuck about that.
Actually, it's two separate arguments. I'm not going to bring it up. But
there's one specific reason I'm happy. But continue.
You can go ahead and say it if you'd like.
I'm just happy that they would all get on a standard and stop having 80 fucking different things. Stop it.
I understand the sentiment.
And also the argument comes from global waste, but continue.
Which is a bunch of horseshit. Yeah. I mean, I'm sorry. That argument is genuinely horseshit.
It's genuinely not, and you know I'm not wrong.
You would immediately create a fuck ton of waste just in cables.
We do anyway.
Exactly. So you're just.
But
you're,
I'm saying I'm.
You're exchanging.
We're discussing one thing for
the exact same thing.
We're discussing the immediate return versus the future. And in the waste argument is the immediate cause of the destruction of all the old cables that would technically be null and void.
Yes.
Which, mind you, still wouldn't be null and void with everything that still uses them. It's the five years into the future where now we've shifted everything to C, and now all those are faded out, and then it's just C from there on out. So
what is the basis that that's going to reduce waste?
Because now I don't need 8 different fucking cables because not everything's proprietary.
Someone, all right, we're going to have to look into studies on this because I don't subscribe to this. And also my issue with it is, so you're going to have a government body dictate the standard and you're going to immediately stifle innovation.
Okay, so, all right. Oh, okay. Ho, ho, ho. Whew. Don't do that because I'm going to bury you with a stupid logic.
You can bury me with stupid logic, but it doesn't make it necessarily right, which is the issue with your stupid logic.
So here's the initial problem. We can both bury the waste argument.
Okay.
Because, sure, we're both saying the same thing. I like to make up the point. I think it does change it technically to an extent. Because then you don't need to keep rebuying a cable every fucking year. But, no, that's not, I'm not wrong. Not wrong.
In a perfect world, you're not wrong. But we're talking about cables. Cables are a disposable thing. Not disposable. Let me rephrase that. Cables are a wear item. Cables are a wear item.
Okay.
You're replacing cables regardless of whether you are using a lightning cable or a USB cable. And I'm sorry, like, if I have an iPad and I have a PlayStation controller and they use 2 separate cables, I'm still, even if you made them the same type of connector, I'm still buying 2 fucking cables. I'm not going to just have 1 cable and be like, this is my charging cable. Let me charge all my devices with it. No fucking person is doing that.
I agree.
Okay. I'm just saying these are like straw man arguments.
You're talking to somebody that downstairs has 1 USB-C coming out of the PlayStation, has a micro USB right there, and a USB-C right there, and 2 other different charging things right here.
Mm-hmm.
Has a micro USB in his bedroom, also a USB-C in his bedroom, has another USB-C at the end of the hall, has another micro USB at the end of the hall. Somewhere has a 30-pin. So
I don't know if we have time for this argument because, like, first off, how many of those cables are charging something and how many of those cables power something?
None of them power anything.
Okay.
I don't have anything that, like, runs on, like a MacBook or anything, you know, that would have... None. I don't have anything that's that new that runs on the power of it. Charge... The other one's tablet charge. The other one's phone charge. Watch charge. Watch charge. Tablet charge. Control. The USB-C downstairs is the PlayStation 1's controller charge. None of them are used to, like, as a power source.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the other one at the end is headphone charge. That's a USB-C. Or USB micro. I just don't think... I'll give you the government... angle, because if we
I reach... love all right so when Nate argues he does this thing where, like, when he's like, I want to argue with you but I don't want to waste time arguing with you, so I'm gonna present your argument in a condescending way. I'm just gonna be like that's beneath me.
I'm giving you the government thing because we would end up in a rabbit hole that immediately drags us away from the conversation. Because the implied statement there flies very off the rails very fast and ends up in a political discussion within the context of the world today. And we end up in just a worse conversation. Because if we're being clear, Matt, these are my cables, my choice. So... my biggest issue with this whole thing is I just hate everybody using proprietary shit constantly. Just stop it. None of it is innovative. None of it. There is zero innovation at this point until actual, like, motherboard sizes, the actual, like, speed on the boards change. You know as well as I do that the $85 monster HDMI cable is just as good as the 6-foot $3 GE HDMI cable. They do the same thing.
That's true. The problem that...
So if I buy a micro USB well, just at this point, it'd be C versus like Micro's out. Micro's essentially been phased out technically anyway.
Yeah.
It's really, which is funny that this whole thing came up anyway, when they're, the picture they used, I don't know which article you looked at, but the picture they used, I think had Micro USB-C, Lightning, and USB-C. And I was like, one of those isn't like the others.
Yeah.
It's really just, it becomes Apple versus the others.
Yeah.
Is the entire conversation. Which is just, they want to just force Apple to use USB-C. I think is what it all comes down to.
Basically.
And I just get annoyed when you just reach that point where you're like, oh, hey, do you have a whatever? No. Like, if you're not in the Apple family,
it's just,
you don't have a cord.
This is such an absurd thing to me, though, because we're talking about, we're not talking like there's eight different things. There's literally two options.
And yeah, it's not at this point, yeah, because like I can't really actually use micro USB as an argument.
Yeah, yeah. It's like,
5 years ago, for sure.
Why are we wait? Like the time wasted on and like the argument over this, it shouldn't even be a thing. Like there is a million other things you could focus all this time, energy, and passion into that would have a exponentially better return on investment.
I'm curious what brought it up to them.
Mm-hmm.
Like what? Where did
I don't even like it? Like the how EU did you, how has did been you, on this like hill for
yeah.
Like
how did you get here?
Yeah.
Here's what I would like rather see them mandate.
Mm-hmm.
No proprietary things.
Yeah, everything's got to be open source.
Open source, and it has to be start eliminating old things. Like keep them as modern. You need to reach like these speeds and this thing.
Yeah.
So it's like, hey, as long as Lightning reaches that speed or USB-C reaches that speed at like you know their minimum end, mm-hmm. fine. Micro USB can't do it. Good, it's out. Done. You know, so, when C and Lightning can't reach it, they have to adapt and make new C, whatever, the higher speed. But the higher speeds are going to come with a port, not the cable. So,
yeah.
I just want to keep seeing things move forward and not get stuck with like, well, USB micro is cheaper to use for us, the manufacturer. So we're going to do that. Like, no, oh my God, stop it. Also, if they want to really look into something about Apple, how about their phones dying after 2 years? I don't know. Maybe, you know, look at that.
I don't think, like,
which people have, that has been brought up before to Apple. And people are like, oh, they've looked at it and there's nothing in there that says performance immediately decreases after 2 years.
Well, no, they did. They did the battery thing, remember?
Yeah.
And they found out that they were basically turning down performance as the batteries got older.
Yeah.
But
it was just like immediate guts because I saw it again with the, was it the 13?
Mm-hmm. My issue
is the
13
the new one?
Yeah, the 13 is the new one.
Somebody was ordering one and they're like, oh, weird that I have my phone going for so long and now I literally can't use it. And oh, the new phone comes out in 2 weeks.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. They're just, it's what killed me was I came across an argument, like not even an argument. People were just like, yeah, of course we should go to USB-C. It's the best thing since sliced bread. And I'm just thinking, like, USB-C is technically better from a spec sheet standpoint. I fucking hate USB-C cables.
Why?
Because, like,
this is actually going to be more telling than anything him and I have argued about right now, is why does the man hate USB-C?
Because, I mean,
it is just a reverse Lightning cable.
Which is fundamentally worse than a Lightning cable. The locking mechanism in a Lightning cable is on the cable, which means that if it goes bad, it can easily be replaced, and you don't have, like, that inside your fucking USB cable to get that itty-bitty dinky little fucking connector that can break off.
The same connector in the Lightning cable.
Which is on the cable, not on the phone. So you know how, like, the USB-C cable circular goes in?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know.
It does this.
Yes.
Instead of doing this.
Well, this part is the phone itself.
Inherently stronger.
And then the locking mechanism is on the cable, whereas the locking mechanism is on the phone.
Okay.
On USB-C.
Can I have another question to you?
Sure, go ahead.
How often does that fuck with you?
Never.
Okay, as long as we're on the same page, never. Where I have never,
which is,
I have never, with a lightning cable or a USB-C or a USB-A or a micro or whatever, had that issue. Kind of
feeds back into my argument, because like the first thing people immediately go to is like, well, USB-C is technically better. Okay. Are you ever going to hit those speeds inside the next two decades? Probably not.
I will, but I'm in a weird scenario. That's not related to like my personal use.
Yes. Okay. That's different.
I hit
that's different
stupid speeds.
And I wouldn't be surprised if you ended up getting stuck with a proprietary connector because of the shit that you have to deal with.
And those I fucking hate and will burn to the ground.
Mm-hmm.
I deal with certain companies where I would rather them never exist and actually drop a nuke on their factory than ever buy from them again. There is a company out there, Matt, who... Fuck the gaming news at this point, because now I'm annoyed that they're... You've seen a server, right? Not to, like, you know,
yeah,
really derail.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's got, we'll say 12 bays in it. In the front. Okay. Three stack by four wide.
Mm-hmm.
What color on the indicator lights in your hard drive should they flash... If they're working.
See, you're not going to win me on this
Your three choices. Or no, I'll give you four choices. Amber.
Okay.
Green.
Okay.
Blue.
Okay.
Red.
I mean, red would be the bad one.
Typical four yeah. lights.
I mean, I'm used to blue.
Yeah, blue's a traditional.
Pretty normal.
Green's up there, but usually green and amber are reserved for, you know, Ethernet jacks.
Yeah.
Okay, so these ones flash red to say they're good.
They're...
You want to know how much I've lost my mind until I finally listen to the ambulance go by?
That's never mind, that's a cop. Soul dying.
Actually, it might have been an ambulance. They're red. I had to actually go print out and paste a thing from like the early 2000s.
That had
their codes on it.
Red's like an old school thing.
Red's still used, but it's actually used, you know, in modern technology for a fucking error.
Yeah.
And some of these machines, they're not old. They're not the early 2000s where I pulled this document from.
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's like, that's an old holdover, like, when red was, like, one of the only LED colors they could do.
These people should be burned at the stake. Because the other option they have, the other LED that's in the server? Blue.
Yeah.
So maybe, hot take. Use the blue one to tell me it's good. They're using the red.
Which is it? A server company?
Yes.
Is it? It's not. And Dell would be cheap. Blue.
No, it's not Dell either. It's not Dell. It's not HP.
Lenovo?
No. I won't touch a Lenovo server.
They
have some security problems.
Well, Dell and HP are the two big ones.
Yeah, it's not either of those.
Okay, I don't know what it is.
It is a cheap. I say this in quotes, build your own alternative.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
There's a specific company.
Yeah. Is it like the popular DIY build your own server company?
Probably, yeah.
Okay.
They show up a lot.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because a lot of people buy from them because they're usually cheaper.
Yeah. Yeah. And like everyone always buys their fucking, like their server bare bones kits.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
We're on the same page.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 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 So bad, I lost my mind. I have that thing printed out and stuck in one of my racks. So that way, whenever
that
I
makes
walk,
complete sense.
So when I like, walk by them, I don't go, "Oh my god, my server's dead." I go, "Wait, hold on. What are the hertz of the codes?" And I'm like scrolling through because it's
I don't think I would enjoy that.
It's panic inducing.
That's like I don't think I would enjoy the responsibility of like. Infrastructure on that level. You know what I mean?
I mean, you live with it.
Yeah. I guess we should go back to video games. I feel better now.
It's been a while since you and I had it out.
I mean, it was more of like a self...
As long as we're on the same side, fuck Apple. And
I just am like, fuck the world at this point.
You know what? I'm fuck the world and fuck Apple.
Yeah.
Individually. One for them.
Side by side.
Side by side?
I think so.
First one, second one's a truck, definitely.
Uh-oh. Getting in some tight situations on this baseball game.
Shocking. No. Oh, am I up?
You are up. Number seven, I believe.
Number seven. Nate hates Apple. Number eight.
Eight's a long one.
I just want to keep going with, like, number seven. Nate thinks lightning adapters are the shittiest thing in the world.
Listen,
I know.
The adapter situation is borderline, like, a crime against humanity.
Dude, so we've been going through this thing, not to get, like, back on this. That's, I think, my biggest issue with the whole thing is adapting between, like, USB-A to C or Lightning to whatever.
And yeah.
It's always just such a fucking nightmare. I would basically need, like, you know, the janitor. I wish I had one of these things. Like, the janitor keys.
Yeah.
Where there's, you're like, how do you know what all those keys go to? And at the same time, it's like, I need that, but USB adapters. Just jingle jangling around. Like, oh, sorry, you're trying to connect those two things? Hold on here. I think I got the right thing for you. Oh, there you go. And, like, flick it to them like I was flicking a quarter into a jukebox across the room. And then Fonz, just give it a quick elbow and boom.
I think we could get more value out of the whole, like, connector situation if we got rid of USB-A and just every USB was USB-C.
It's like, pretty much where we're at kind of going forward. Mm-hmm. Like, a lot of modern laptops are starting USB-C. To follow the Mac thing.
Yeah.
We're like, oh, did you want USB-C-A? Oh, did you want an Ethernet jack? Oh, fuck you.
Well, see, that's bullshit. I think, as far as just USB goes, we should get rid of USB-A and just have USB-C for everything. But,
yeah. No, they've started stripping just everything.
Yeah, they're just like one USB-C port. That's all you get.
I've got ones with three. Three USB-C. No video out. You can't even, like, plug an HDMI cable
and
in.
There's probably, like, this one's USB-C, like, USB 3. And this one's like USB 3.2 or whatever.
It's like
they're not even like fully specced out. It's like this one's just half the standard. All right, we're getting in the weeds.
Number seven, and couple news outlets with separate sources, including Kotaku, are reporting that Quantic Dream is developing a Star Wars game. All the Star Wars games. According to multiple sources, the game in question has been in development for 18 months. That'd be a year and a half, in case people are trying to do the math at home. Although, we should take all of this with a grain of salt. I got an 18-month joke for you after this, by the way. Remind me of that. We should take this with a grain of salt. Here's what the rumors are. It won't be the conventional type of quick-time event-driven game we've come to expect from Quantic. Instead, they said the game will have more traditional action gameplay and possibly even open-world and multiplayer elements. EA's deal with Lucasfilms is in effect until 2023, but it looks like Disney is planning for the future and wants a bevy of games ready for release when the time comes. Hence why all the other games are showing up.
Yep.
The 18-month joke thing is, I saw somebody we both know post something about their child.
Okay.
They used a month designation. And I was like, just tell me he's a year and a half.
Yeah, I got in this argument. Not an argument, but I said the same thing to Samantha. I was like, why does everyone always refer to their kids as being like 18
after,
months old?
After 12
months old. I'm
after
like, they're a year. They're a year
say,
old. They're
after
year
the
half.
1 year mark hits, you never refer to them by month anymore.
Yeah.
I'll up until then, because obviously you don't say 0.7 of a year.
Yeah, you're not going to. You could. I guess you get away with like, oh, he's half a year old.
You get away like, with that, but like.
Seven months, 8 months, you know.
Yeah, those all make sense. Not, you know, he looks like he's 15 months old, and you're like,
there's
just
probably
a year in some change.
It's probably, like, something that's happened because of, like, how they do, like, children's clothing.
That's exactly what my guess is, because of how they do children's clothing. Because
and it's
they...
probably some psychological thing where they found that, like, if they said something was 18 months more
was,
people bought it or something like that.
I was going to make a way worse joke than that.
Okay, that's fair.
I was going to go with uneducated parents that don't understand a year and a half is 18 months and got real confused.
Could be the case too.
Hell yeah, that guy. Bang on that wall.
Yeah. Back to sports. What's up with all the people running on the fields lately?
Everybody forgot how to act during a pandemic, and I hope those people instead were getting shot by snipers from the stands.
Yo, I saw the one tackle, and I was like, that's what people need me to do.
It was a great tackle. I still don't know what the guy had in his hand.
I think it was a cell phone.
Because he had, it was decently large, though. So I wasn't sure if he had like a true camera mm-hmm. or something.
Maybe. GoPro or something.
Yeah, but it was a good spear.
It was.
It all depends on the jurisdiction of the stadiums and stuff like that. But a bunch of people, humans, forgot how to act.
Yep.
And I would love to see them actually get full tased.
Tasing would be good.
Or straight up shot in the knee.
I think what they should do is the fucking net guns.
Those would be great too. But I would love to truly see like arrow to the knee from a fucking archer at like the top of the stands. Yeah. Just.
Or we could get real brutal and have attack dogs.
I'm down. Yeah. Let them loose.
The sports stadiums just turn into fucking like Roman Colosseums.
Yeah. You jump down there, you die.
Yeah.
Whoever's the batter is allowed to swing at you. You come near them, they're allowed to take their bat and drive it through your skull. Because you're fucking stupid. And honestly, the world's not going to miss you.
That's fair. That's fair.
Just a hot take. But I'm sick of it. Because people forgot how to act during a fucking pandemic somehow.
It's like everyone wants attention. It's just like,
it's the part of me that says I wish they got more than they got. Because again, it depends on stadium and jurisdictions and everything like that. Sometimes it's up to a $10,000 fine plus 10 days in jail and you're banned from the stadium and then potentially all stadiums for life and type of yada yada. But those are all like dependent on a lot of things. Same thing with the jackass Yankee fan that threw the ball at Verdugo two, 3 months ago now. It's like that man should have been arrested and tried for assault. And fuck his entire life up for being a jackass. Because he deserves it. He's an idiot. Go there. You're not part of the team. It's not about you. You're there to enjoy entertainment. That'd be like getting mad in the movie theater and throwing a milkshake from 13 rows back and nail in the middle of the screen. Like, fuck you. Go home. And then go to prison. Go home, get your life together, and then go to prison. Just go submit yourself. You deserve to be there. You clearly have deep-rooted issues.
I see that you have strong feelings on this topic.
Had I been more of a brazen man, I would have liked to fist fight half the people sitting around us at the Yankee game.
Like, yeah, that was pretty bad.
That one drunk jackass who might have been 21, two rows back to our left, and then the other ones who, again, might have been 21, the group of five to our right,
yeah.
Who, in their heckling, don't understand how anything works, calling the current right fielder at the time the 30th worst right fielder in the league. When also wasn't true, man has a World Series championship and yada yada. And you're like, what are you? Oh, you're some loser fan sitting in the stands because you didn't make it. And you're a child. That man would fuck you up. Not to mention then the other guy with the judge thing. Matt, why?
All right.
Why do we do this? Why are you getting me going?
It's a hate podcast now, this week at least. Hey, Nintendo.
I fucking hate this movie.
Nintendo hit us with a surprise direct. Let's recap, as per tradition.
Give me your other water.
Okay.
No, the one you forgot from last time.
This one's unopened.
Oh, well, I figured you just didn't want to leave a stagnant one sitting under a lamp for 5 days.
That's fine.
Nice photo, dude.
Mario Party Superstars is coming on October 29th, so they showed a look at that. If you want to comment on any of these, feel free to jump in.
Nope, it was like, hey, good job. Cool.
Monster Hunter Rise had a massive quote. That's quote, massive. Expansion announced, which will be called Sunbreak, coming sometime in summer of 2022.
Good for them.
Another card game, Voice of Cards, The Isle Dragon Roars, is out on October 28th.
No idea.
Disco Elysium, The Final Cut, was shown again. The digital release is coming October 12th, with a physical release coming in early 2022. Nintendo showed off the second content pack for Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity, coming out October 29th. There's a lot of October 29th, October 28th stuff going on.
Yeah, right before Halloween.
We got a look at Chocobo GP, which looks like a Mario Kart clone. One of the cool features is 64-player bracket-based online tournaments. Nintendo announced some other directs, which was interesting. Set for October, which will show the final character coming to Smash Ultimate and new content for Animal Crossing. So I didn't actually watch the direct, but from what I could understand from a couple different articles, is they like kind of teased multiple directs and they were going to be specific about like based around these games. I'm assuming they're going to be like the tiny, what are they called? Little directs?
Mini directs.
Mini directs. Can't remember if they were like mini or micro or whatever.
Honestly, I'm not positive that I'm right on mini, so
doesn't really matter. Kirby and
focused directs, I kind of like.
That does sound
which clearly means Nintendo would never call it that.
Yeah, too legit
to quit.
Kirby and the Forgotten Land coming spring 2022.
New Kirby game.
Yep, first of the series, full 3D.
Yeah. Kind of cool. Haven't really had a true new Kirby game in a while. We had that one when the Switch first started. There was that free Kirby, kind of like multiplayer option thing that was there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, cool to see an actual full Kirby. I still want Kirby's Air Ride back. Matt has no idea what I'm talking about, but somebody out there that has a GameCube will appreciate what I said.
Yeah, I know nothing about Nintendo, but I did see the length of the Direct. And listing out everything that they announced, I was like, good for you, Nintendo.
Kirby's Air Ride, I don't even remember exactly what the goal was. I think you were fighting each other on vehicles. I think. I don't remember 100%. I just remember that my cousin and I, because you were in the city, and you would run around and get on different vehicles and like fly around and stuff. I just remember my cousin and I like always racing to go find where vehicles were and then just flying around. I just remember having a ton of fun. I don't remember even what the game was, though. I don't remember what I was supposed to be doing. I just remember having a ton of fun flying around the city.
I mean, that's what games are for.
So much pure innocence. When I know we're getting a new James Bond, but when's Nightfire getting remade? You know?
I saw, like, someone did a post on Reddit that was like, what was it? It said something along the lines of, like, games don't hit like they used to.
It's a combo of, like, I think we're also just old.
I think it's partly that, but I also think their reasoning was that with like the like streaming and all that, now people are like they are trying to use games as like a way to like make money and do stuff like that. So it kind of like changes the
there's part
the value.
Of that, yeah.
So,
but yeah, there was not hitting as much as they used to.
Yeah.
I do have that moment every now and then. Like I've. Currently, not to like derail the Nintendo thing, but I've currently kind of been like chasing that dragon at the moment. I'm in that kind of loop. Like, I have the Ghost of Tsushima DLC, mm-hmm. I have Uncharted 2 ready to go downstairs, and I'm still kind of like going, like, oh, yeah, you know, I got some stuff in MLB and I got WoW and Splitgate, but none of them are like, nothing has bit me to.
Yeah,
like, so really sucked me in again.
I've been in that state for a while where I've been like chasing the dragon, but also like nothing's been interesting to me. So like I've been playing less and less as the years have gone on.
So, I think my true breakout moment is going to be Far Cry.
Yeah,
that will always suck me.
Suck you?
Yeah, I was like I realized I hiccuped at like the worst time right there. Far Cry will always suck me in, and then that'll kind of give me like a month before Forza, which again, I'll lose myself in Forza.
Yeah. I think that's part of it more than anything else, is it seems worse than it actually is just because of like
everything we're really looking forward to has either been delayed or is like on the edge.
Yeah. And games just aren't coming out in the same frequency because of like COVID and generation shift. So
yeah,
it's kind of like a lull.
And even comparing a frequency to us as a child, we didn't pay attention to frequency at that point.
Yeah.
It was like, I got Nightfire. Guess what I'm playing forever?
Yeah.
I am going to be Knick Knack. And I'm this short little guy whose head you can barely see above the wall. Oh, just Tom Brady really likes Subway now. They paid him a lot of money.
This is so weird. Anyways, Disney Magical World 2 Disney Magical World 2 Enchanted Edition will be out this holiday. It's a Switch port of the original 3DS game. Mario Golf is getting two new characters, Koopa and Ninji, alongside two new courses. Koopa. The content all comes in a free update made available day of the Direct.
Oh, hey, so out now.
Yep. The original Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic is getting a Switch port available November 11th. That is not the remake. Say,
that's the original.
That is the original original.
I was like, you imagine if that was the remake?
That'd be whack. Dying Light Platinum Edition is making its way to Switch on October 19th. And Dying Light 2 Stay Human will be on the Switch February 4th.
Yeah, say, when it actually comes out.
Yeah.
Now that it got pushed.
Mm-hmm. Project Triangle Strategy received a release date March 4th, 2022. Metroid Dread got a trailer before its October 8th launch. Nintendo announced the new membership plan launching in late October for Nintendo Switch Online. They're calling it an expansion pack, and it gives you access to a slew of N64 and Sega Genesis games. No pricing yet, though.
Yeah, the Sega part was cool.
They're also releasing retro wireless controllers if you want the whole experience. So, like, I'm talking, like, legit N64 controller and Sega Genesis controllers.
Probably $85 each.
Dude, for that much, I will fucking...
The Joy-Cons are $80.
Yeah, but we're talking, like, old-ass controllers that just have a wireless component built into them.
But I think even, like, their wired GameCube controllers are, like, $50.
Yo, they are, like, these game controllers, man.
They are bending you over and taking you for all you're worth.
Basically. The Shadow...
Let's go! Give me your money!
The Shadowrun Trilogy is coming to Switch in 2022. Castlevania Advance Collection came out Day of the Direct. ActRaiser Renaissance and Deltarune Chapter 2 also out Day of the Direct.
As we love right now.
Exactly. Some more ports. Hot Wheels Unleashed, September 30th. Surviving.
There it is.
Yeah. Oh, I saw.
You hype?
I'm pretty thrilled about it.
You're gonna be out there racing on those plastic tracks?
I might be. I guess it depends on how. Well, yeah. There's really nothing else going on unless
you're not doing anything else.
Unless I, New World. I might do New World.
Oh, interesting.
So,
I'm only doing New World if I get it for free. By that, I mean I've entered a few giveaways.
I mean, that's fair.
Not my cup of tea, so I'm not going to spend money on it. So it's if I get it for free, I'll give it a shot.
That's fine. I kind of just like trying MMOs, so I don't really mind.
If there was like a 2-week trial period, like there is sometimes for MMOs, you know, like the, you can only get your character up to like level 10 or whatever, then I would do that, but I don't think that exists for the beginning of the game. For like the first launch of the game, mm-hmm. I should say.
Anyways, ports. Surviving the Aftermath. Shimiganzi Tensei, I fucking hate saying that. 5, Wreckfest, Arcade.
Shimigami Tensei 5?
Yeah.
Okay. Just so long of a pause between Tensei and then 5, I was like, yeah, those aren't two different games, right?
Arcade Archives, Pac-Man, Arcade Archives, XZS? I don't know.
Okay.
Rune Factory 5. And then anyways, moving on. Apparently, there's a Mario movie in the works, and they revealed the cast.
They revealed the cast.
Would you like me to start with Mario or finish with Mario?
Finish with Mario. Go with order of least importance first.
I'm going to do the reverse order of whatever I put down here. Okay. Spike is Sebastian Maniscalco. I don't know who that is. K-Mac is Kevin Michael Richardson, whoever that is. Don't know that either. Cranky Kong is Fred Armisen. Donkey Kong is Seth Rogen. Toad is Keegan-Michael Key. Bowser is Jack Black. Luigi is Charlie Day. Peach is Anna Taylor-Joy. And finally, Mario is Chris Pratt.
What is this casting? Can Chris Pratt do an Italian accent?
All right, so what do you think is more likely? Scenario A, which is that somehow Chris Pratt has a crazy Mario accent that we're gonna that actually works and we just don't know about it. Scenario B, where they're trying to make Mario, I don't even know how to say it. I was gonna say cool, but that's not what I want to say. You know what I'm saying here. They're gonna try to make Mario modern and American, like, hip.
American and not a Italian stereotype.
Yeah.
So I don't know if you saw the comments from Chris.
I did not.
He has said,
okay,
he has a voice for Mario, and they've been working it very hard to make sure it's good, and that he's excited for all of us to hear it. But that he is 100% doing a voice for Mario.
Okay.
I don't know.
So the breakdown here.
I'm still just so unbelievably more confused because they're going to have voices, and it's like,
yeah, and it's,
Jack Black is Bowser. Weird.
I have faith in Jack Black in general, just because he does all sorts of wonky shit.
I got faith in Jack. But let's be clear. These are actual people voicing characters that aren't voiced normally.
That was where I was going to go.
Okay.
So, running down the names that I do know, Keegan-Michael Key, amazing talent.
Yeah, and I'm sure him to do a Toad voice would be just fine.
Jack Black is, you get, Jack Black is talented, but you get Jack Black is a thing.
Yeah, you get Jack. Yeah,
exactly. Charlie Day, amazingly talented. I don't know, like, about his voice acting things that he's got going on, but, like, I know he's a good writer and he's a good actor and all that good stuff. Like, funny, at least. I think he could do a really cool Luigi. I don't know. It just kind of seems like the personalities fit. Anna Taylor-Joy, I haven't seen a ton of her stuff, but it's Peach. Like, I mean, come on. Of all of these characters, I feel like Peach is, like, the easiest one to, like...
Peach is the only one where, like, you really can't fuck that up.
Yeah, you can't fuck Peach up. Seth Rogen, Donkey Kong, I don't fucking know. Whatever.
Again, maybe it's, like, Surfer Kong.
That's the one that made me think. Because, like, when I got to Seth Rogen and Donkey Kong, I was like, what? How do you do Donkey Kong? And then that got me thinking in that mindset, and I went back through. I'm like, wait, none of these people are, like, voiced. Like, this is going to be... Like, what's going on here?
I'm waiting for the weed joke for Donkey Kong.
So...
Like, can Rogen throw in a Blaze It joke?
Oh, yeah. So, like, I don't know. This is going to be something.
Yeah. Put it this way. I don't know if I'm going to watch it.
I mean, I'm out regardless, but...
Well, I know you're out regardless. This is one where, like, even if I got it through another way,
mm-hmm.
I don't think I'd watch it.
Yeah, well...
I can't wait to see the memes come out of it, though, because I'm betting there's going to be some quality memes.
Yeah. Yeah. And then the last two things is Splatoon 3, Rise of the Mammalians. Is that how you say that? Mammalians? Mammary glands? Got a gameplay trailer.
Rise of the Mammary glands.
Got a gameplay trailer.
You wanted to talk about the life motto downstairs. That's the fucking the war that you have to participate in when you're trying to plug those holes.
Bayonetta 3 also got a trailer. It was announced in 2017, by the way.
Yeah, I remember that.
So apparently it'll be out next year.
Uh-huh. We'll see. Yeah. So anything else?
That's it for Nintendo.
All right. Some things we didn't write full paragraphs on. Riot has launched a PC client, although you can keep your existing desktop shortcuts if you want.
Because that's what we need.
Kind of makes sense for them. Like, it's annoying, obviously, but yeah. they don't exist on, like, a Steam or anything unless you import your...
Mm-hmm. And they have, like, multiple games now. So.
Yeah, now they have 3 games, and they're working on their MMO, so that'd make it 4. Annoying, but you can understand why.
Yeah.
It's not like the Bethesda or Rockstar ones where they've been existing on other ones and then went, eh, you know what, ours. Or Ubisoft, same thing.
Yeah.
And EA. Well, not EA, actually. Number two, Valve announced that its latest Steam Next Fest is coming the first week of October, giving access to playable demos of hundreds of upcoming PC games. Exciting. Fun times.
Mm-hmm.
Always good when those happens. And number three, the Chinese version of the app TikTok, known as Douyin, will limit users in China who are under 14 years old to 40 minutes a day, which is roughly 700 TikToks.
That's disgusting.
I don't know how that math works, but...
did you make that up?
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Oh, okay.
You said it with such confidence. I might not be far off, but...
You said it with such confidence that I was like, all right, that sounds legit.
How long is a TikTok?
I don't know. I've never... I'm proud to say I have never, like... I have seen TikToks in passing because you cannot avoid them via, like, whatever. But, like, I have never actively... downloaded, looked at the app, or gone to its website if it does have one.
It does have one. Okay. I've never downloaded the app, and I've never gone to the website out of my own volition. It's usually like somebody sends me a link, and they're like, oh, hey, check out this one or something, and I'm like, okay, I'll take a look at it. But
yeah,
there's no, or like I'll see them in Snapchat or Twitter because like people can like share them. So they'll just be in my feed, but I never go seek out TikTok at all.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Proud to say I am TikTok clean. So it's been it's been 7 days. What you been up to?
We finished It Takes Two.
Yeah. How was that?
It was good. It was good. It was longer than I thought it would be, but not. It's not a bad thing.
That's what she said.
Yeah. Right. And that's, I think.
So were you like halfway through, you think, when last week? Because you said
maybe a little bit more than halfway.
Like sure, where?
Yeah, probably like 2/3 of the way through, or maybe halfway. But
did you have your actual time to beat?
I didn't see it anywhere. So okay. I'm not sure.
Because what did we say it was, like 10 hours?
I think it was longer than that. I think it was like 12 to 16 or something like that.
Okay.
Yeah, so did that, and I don't think I haven't really played anything else. I've just been kind of chilling. What did I watch? I think I watched something that I kind of remember updating the doc, but I don't. Oh, Star Wars Visions came out. Did you not see the? So a bunch of anime creators are doing an episode a piece. They're like 15 to 20 minute episodes.
Okay.
And there's like each like famous or well-known anime creators are each doing a single episode, and they're all self-contained little like 15 to 20 minute long stories. They're calling them Star Wars Visions.
Okay. All right.
I watched I think there's 9, 10. I don't know. I watched the first three. Interesting. The first one was amazing. The next two were not so much, and that's where we're at. So
always good.
Mm-hmm. And that's
how many was it?
I want to say it was like maybe 10.
Okay, all right. So chance to redeem itself then.
Yeah, yeah. I know.
Are they so individual story or individual episodes? Is it like what they were doing with Mando, where it was different directors, but they're telling an overall story, or is it individual stories?
It's kind of like Marvel's What Ifs.
Okay, all right. Like,
so they're non-canon, just kind of like stories.
Of course they're non-canon, because Disney doesn't know what's fucking canon anyway.
Well, they're very anime, so like some of them, they're all stylized like certain ways. So like the first one, for example, was very like Akira Kurosawa. Like, black and white, samurai, like...
Yeah, everything that is curious.
Yes, film grain, all that.
Yeah, yeah, delay on the mouth.
One of them was, like, the over-the-top anime, like Red Line. I don't know if you've ever seen that...
I don't know.
That movie. Like, for example, a Jedi-esque character was on the nose of an X-Wing, like, riding it.
Oh,
so like
okay.
It's they're
that
all
over the top.
They're all like stylized, yeah, like in a yeah. certain way.
When so. How is studio doing one? Because oh my god, would that be depressing?
I don't remember the exact creators and who's doing what. There was one that I saw that had this like a similar art style, so it might be some people who
work you know, there. Yeah.
But
it would be very funny to see.
What I suggest doing is I watch them, and Samantha was like sitting in the living room with me. She wasn't really watching them, but I was like Mystery Science Theater 3000-ing them. Like I was
the old
like
comments on.
Yeah. Like I was like when there was ones that were clearly not like going to be ones that I like, I would just be like heckling them the whole time. So
I want to see like, what is it? My Neighbor Totoro, but Ewok Adventures.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just them on Endor loving it.
Yeah. See, that would be cool.
That bright stylized.
The one of them that I watched, I think it was the second one, was like a rock, was like a rock band.
Like the Cantina Band gone rock, essentially.
Well, I say rock band, but really it was like the fucking music from last weekend, from like the 90s, 2000s, like that.
Oh,
like
old Godsmack.
Not even that, like kind of more on the punk side.
Boxcar Racer.
Yes. But done poorly.
Oh, well, of course, yeah.
So I was just
there's a translation miss.
Yeah. Yeah, well, they didn't quite get it right.
Yeah.
So it was just like, I was rough. I was like, I don't know about this.
Oh, I love it.
That one got some, I ripped into that one pretty good. And then the one with like, that was over the top with like, you know, dude riding basically, a fucking X-Wing. Yeah. I was like, just.
Like Neo.
I was like ripping it apart because like it's Star Wars. So like, you know, like. Like, there's a big crystal. I'm like, oh, they're going to play with the fucking kyber crystal. And the guy's like, oh, my kyber crystal. I was like, what did I say? Like, I was just, like, tearing it apart. Like, they've got to hit all these fucking cliches. And Samantha was just over there, like, chuckling. Because I was like, this.
Yeah, because you had lost your mind.
Yeah, basically. I was just, like, ripping into it. Like, calling things. And then it would end up being the case. And I was just like, well, that was obvious. Fucking. And, like, they showed, I'm like. Like, it starts off, and there's, like, an outline of, like, stars, and, like, you could see the outline of a ship. I'm like, oh, it's a Star Destroyer, and then you see the outline of Star Destroyer, and it starts pulling back, and I'm like, oh, I'm Star Wars. You know what's cooler than one Star Destroyer? Two of them put together, and it was two Star Destroyers. I'm like, and you know what? Let's put a big fucking cannon in the middle, and then they're, like, you see them, and there's a giant cannon in the middle. I'm like, didn't see that one coming. I was just, like, ripping it apart, like...
It's everything that I love when we watch movies with people that, but everybody hates us at the same time because yeah. Those are just such, so much fun to do when you know the movie's going to suck.
Yeah. So that made it like fun to watch.
Yeah.
So
that's, I mean, you were your own entertainment at that point.
Exactly. That was my week. Other than that, it was just boring shit. How about you?
Yeah, you know, same shit. Different day for me.
Yeah, nothing new, really.
Yeah, really nothing new for me. It's, I mean,
work, nothing new for anyone, really. We gotta wait for shit to come out.
Working games. And
did you raid this week?
Yeah, I just did my normal.
Normal.
Nothing.
No mythic. Right.
Yeah, no. I think the guy that I was supposed to be subbing for ended up not having to do what he was doing, so I was not needed. But whatever. Hey, works for me.
Yeah. You'll get in there eventually.
Still got to raid it a little bit. Yeah, I'll still at some point probably be in there, hopefully. If not, then nah, you know, I'm not. If I do, I do. It's not like I'm...
Yeah.
I'm not pushing for top 100 here, you know.
Not yet.
We're a ways off, man. Let's just bring it back.
We'll see.
Yep, that's all I got then.
Yeah, I'm good.
All right, well, we'll see you guys in 7 days. Bye-bye!
Acast powers some of the world's best podcasts. Here's a show we recommend.
Hey everyone, Cameron Abadi here, deputy editor at Foreign Policy. So when I think about economics podcasts, the words fun or exciting don't really come to mind. Then I started working with Adam Tooze. Readers of FP know Adam as an economic historian and a popular author. But he's more than that. In some ways, he's an encyclopedia about everything.
How a big multinational like Ford or GM operates has a huge impact on...
By 2018, life expectancy was 78 and a half, where we...
Historically unprecedented increase in poverty.
On each episode of Ones and Twos, Adam Twos and I will unpack several data points. I'm pretty sure you won't look at the world the same way.
Acast recommends.